everybody. You're listening to Dead Air. Alright, we're back for episode 2 of our playthrough as the Empire in Awakening of the Rebellion 2.9. And let's see. Let's turn on all the things. And let me reassess like where we're at. This is one of the areas where we have some of the greatest threat. We have the medium dockyard. I mean, to me, I view this as almost, I'm kind of leaving this a trap here. Like I'm inviting them to attack, sort of, a little.
Right away.
But, let's see. We have, what's being built here? Oh. Stormtroopers. We need the money coming in. I don't like running my money too low if I can avoid it, because if in case there is a battle, a land battle, like if I get raided, I want to try to be able to have some money to build some turrets and so on if I can. But that's just something I try to do. I don't know how good I am at that. But let's see. How about this? Tell me what's at Bothroom. And I want good information on this. Tell me what's really at Ord Mantell. This, if there's no fleet there,
Soldiers.
I can't help but think that if I could pool my fleet together here, get everything to build Bringy, maybe I can hit Ord Mantell and at least take out the space structures, which might get me on the way toward being able to take it. So I want to take part of the plan here is whenever possible, I want to take Ord Mantell. Because I want these other planets back here that allow for mining. Mining planet, Ilum is as well. And of course we'll want Jeddah. But this will be the key point to being able to defend so much of this area. But Ord Mantell is going to be... It seems like any time I play, Ord Mantell is just a key planet I'm wanting to get. I don't know... I guess if I'm playing as the Rebellion, maybe not so much so. But... You know what, though? I'm gonna go ahead and get all of these ships.
Moving to coordinates. Order confirmed.
As you wish.
Navigating.
Let's put that together there. I kind of wouldn't mind taking this fleet to Rhodia just to see what's there. I know Zar should be... Let's go ahead and just go there. Just to see what's there, but we're going to be retreating from there almost certainly. And I didn't even put anything in the Pathfinder position anyway, so... Which, I don't know how much that's really going to matter here. But what all, how much stuff shows up there? Because simply put, with Zar, there is no ground battle. It's space only. And it's behind the lines for me, basically. So, what at any point I can take this, and of course it's a planet that allows for the building of a Tavanna gas refinery. Whenever we get those going. I don't know, there's not that much here.
Star Destroyer standing by. Star Destroyer reporting in. Moving to coordinates.
Are there no structures here? He's moving forward. Let's see. Let's see what happens here. Maybe we'll have more fun here than I thought.
Yes, Commander.
Heute bereit, sir.
Awaiting orders.
Haben wir Jägerunterstützung? Ziel auf 2-9.
Awaiting your orders.
Kreuzer bereit, sir. Kurs gesetzt. Ziel auf 2-9.
Awaiting your command.
Imperial missile destroyer here. Combat maneuvers initiated.
Forces ahead.
So what? Well, let's see.
Commander? Reporting in.
I mean, how much more does he have here? I don't know. You know what? Retreat out of here. I got a good look at something, but I want more stuff together before I attempt this. Let me look at what's happening in my dreadnought that quickly. They have quite a few little small artillery type ships there, like those Marauders. I don't know how many there are, but I'm gonna want to be able to do something about those. Now, about combining my fleet, like, more as well. This, I was saying I wanted to defend on the ground. What is that? Do I not have a dockyard or anything of any kind? No. I got nothing? If I go here, I can retreat from there. I should retreat to Cato Nemordia. Nemordia. Okay. If I can at some point combine these fleets and take the space at Manan. If I go from Intersection 4 to Todaio, would I retreat to Manan? If I control the space there, or intersection 4. Probably back to here.
Of course, sir.
Construction complete.
What? Let's get a couple of these in here with it, maybe be able to attack Czar. So, I mean, Czar, it doesn't really do me any good. I mean, nothing about this does me much of any good until I'm actually going to be building the Tabana gas refineries. So, I mean, I just don't need to be worried about it right now. I can just defend it in Naboo. And 7,200 to upgrade to that.
Enlisting troops. Tactical battle imminent.
That scared me for a second. I forgot. It's like, yep, I had them flying into there. Okay. It scared me. Oh, it's something that I thought was interesting. It's like less than, it's less than 24 hours since I released episode one. And I just don't get a whole lot of views. I mean, there's just not. I mean, I get a handful of views, that's it. But in less than 24 hours, that's already one of my top viewed videos I've ever made. I haven't made that many videos, but it's like, well, it seems like hopefully this will be a popular series or something. Maybe I'll end up with more viewers than I have had before. So, do go ahead and like and subscribe, if you will, so forth. And just... anyway, welcome to episode 2 again. Okay, tell me it's going there. Yeah, alright. So far, at least my idea. Okay, so that had to have been building the mobile thing. Okay. And I got an Arquintons. Do we want... what is the size of this fleet right now? It's only 46. Let's get this Arquintons up there.
Jumping to sector.
Heading out.
Let's see, did they stay there? What's the deal here? Why does that fleet not... and this is going to give us top... if nothing else, at least bringing this Arquintons up gives me the probe droid time to go ahead and get to Ord Mantell and get me better intel. And I'm sure that the ground battle there is not something I'm ready to handle. But we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Right now I'm looking at trying to do some damage.
System lost.
Okay, the Rebellion finally set foot on Jägermeister and took it away from me. It's about time. You've been in orbit for a while and nothing on the surface. Here, Quintin's is getting close. Ord Mantell. What all? Ship refitter. Sky Dagger, was it? A medium pirate base. See, this is a... those three mirror cruisers. Oh, those things are so OP right now. Five Eddy cruisers. Five interceptor frigates. Two Sea-Rock Pizzantes. I mean, that's quite a compliment to go along with, you know, what you've already got is a pretty powerful space station here. Starbase. I'm not feeling good about this. I'll tell you one thing I would actually want more of. I need to build a lot more Arquentins. And what is the base income of 50?
Constructing.
Boost that up. I need more defense there. I need more defense here.
Beginning construction.
That runs my money down lower than I want. But once we get these built, we're gonna be. We've kind of got a fleet here that's so we're defended here reasonably well. Our defense is we're building up defenses is what we're doing. What all the hell is coming at this? I would want more Arquentins before I attack there. Arquentins are pretty good. I mean, as far as our early game goes, it's our artillery. That's, you know. But I have the closest thing to real tanks that I have are the ISDs. You got Vader and Ozzel. But with as much firepower as they have, I need to be able to take out that enemy firepower rapidly. An ISD is not going to hold up to firepower like that for long. So, I guess I need to focus on defenses and economics. That's it. I mean, so as soon as the next week goes and turns by,
complete.
I'll upgrade this to an Imperial Palace.
Reporting for duty, sir.
Just set. On the way.
Get some stuff on the ground here to defend here. We need to build some more mines here. Turn this into a money producer. Gotta focus in on our economy, I guess. That's the smart move here, I think.
Heading in that direction.
Well, there's no fleet there threatening anything. I don't think there's anything at AOTR. Just for the fun of it. Just to do something.
As the Emperor will.
Let's try to hit Intersection 5 if it's not overly defended, which I seriously doubt it would be. But let's try to hit that and with the intention of immediately returning to Bill Briggy. He can take back Intersection 5, but maybe let's destroy whatever's there. I mean, it's dangerous to leave Bill Briggy uncovered, but it doesn't look like it's under direct threat at the moment. That's going to take 7,500. Oh, wait, what are you guys doing in space?
Reporting.
What happened there? I know why they were in space because I sent them there. They're just moving through here because I don't have anything in orbit. I guess they're just freely moving through Eridus space. Okay. Well, here, let's get intersection 5 going.
Tactical battle imminent.
Oh shoot, this is a neutral. So, but that's a custom station instead of a battle station of any kind. I got a battle dragon I need to be worried about. Let's try to take this. Why does it look like I'm... It looks like I'm in a freaking asteroid field before I even get going, but it doesn't show up on the mini-map that way, so I guess I'm not.
Kurs gesetzt. Ziel auf 29.
Choose your reinforcements.
They're awfully far back up in there. I mean, that station is way back in there. Are the rest of them that far back?
Because
I would like to be inside of this squeeze point instead of having to be in, you know. That is, on this side of it, not inside as in between. So what do you think there, Vader? Let's see what you have to say.
Crews are ready.
Warm up.
Doesn't seem to be doing anything to it.
Light crews are reporting. I'll be promoted for this.
I wish I could see better, like, where... I have to wear glasses, by the way, nowadays. Oh, here it is.
TIE Interceptor here. Interceptor TIE squad reporting.
We'll scan the area immediately. We're having difficulty tracking them.
Okay, this is probably annoying to watch. Sorry about that. Okay, that's one, two.
IPV reporting. Awaiting command.
Yes, sir.
So basically an Arquintans can't hit an Arquintans, I guess?
Destroyer here.
Let's see if I can get them to come out and play. Come on, bring it there. Come on, get out of there. Doesn't have enough range to do that. My God, how much you gotta eat there? Oh, I don't want to be around this thing with my fighters. Oh, they're going back in there.
Arquitan's ready.
Well, what is this thing that's moving? Okay, well.
As you wish, my lord. We've spotted the enemy fleet.
Oh, this battle dragon, what am I thinking?
Comm channel open, sir. They are no match for us.
Come on, kill that thing. Maybe you need to stop. No, that's gonna hurt. Okay, all you big boats. Be a big boat and go ahead and shoot that. Get rid of that thing. If nothing else though, by taking out this, I just thought about it. Kind of a downside, at least these guys were getting in the way of the Black Sun moving back and forth through here. Stop moving. Invader,
we'll scan the area immediately. Yes, my lord. We're having difficulty tracking them.
Yes, sir. Our Quitton's crews are ready.
Thank you. Well, this thing shouldn't be a real threat anyway.
Vengeance is ours, men. The spirits of our fallen brothers will sleep soundly tonight.
Well, this has been kind of dull. We end up taking that out. But like I said, on the downside, that was, I was expecting this to be something controlled by the Black Sun. It was not. So, now we're going to be leaving it. And so now it's in, you know, Black Sun's able to just move through there at will. While I had the fleet together, I could have just hit Jeddah maybe. But I want to get back to Bill Bringing it, wanting to play it safer here. What all is here? Black Sun Palace. What all the... One Enforcers and one Disruptor. Of course, we have Distant Black Sun Outpost. This is, by the way, if you're not familiar with the Black Sun, and it's... People think it's real overpowered, but they're able to get this. This is something that allows them to build some basic units, but it also offers the defenses. But it can't be upgraded. This is it. This is the end-all, be-all of it. Like, so much of the Black Sun, none of their buildings can be upgraded. So, basically, the units that they get, they really depend on being able to bring in mercenaries from other things and so on in order to be able to be strong. And, it's... So their strengths come from different sources. But there's still nothing else. But we do need... we're just going to defend. That's right. Still eyeballing Ord Mantell. They can all go hit it while there's no fleet there. Hey, maybe the Rebellion will hit it when there's no fleet there. Yeah, do that, Rebellion. Go ahead. You got Jägermeister right there. There's just free space stations there. Go ahead. Hit that. But I need to be thinking about economics. I can't really buy a Tabana gas refinery there. I could build another asteroid mining colony here.
Building under construction.
I kind of want to have something more defensive here at Kessel, as tempting as it might be. Okay, since on to Kessel. How the hell? What the fuck? How am I supposed to get to Kessel? None of these guys are stealth units. I mean, Jar Jar Rod is put down here at Aerodel. Which he is a governor, by the way. So, base income of 100. So basically, with that 100%, he's giving me another 100 governor bonus plus 100. So I'm getting 100 a week to leave him on the ground here. But he is an admiral, and it's only a 5% bonus, which really isn't that big of a deal. Unless if you have a fleet where you have Ozl in it, because Ozl is the bad guy, you know, the bad admiral, the minus 10% combat bonus for all ships. So if there's any admiral at all in there with him, such as that plus 5, that negates that. You always use your best admiral. So any admiral in with him completely negate. It doesn't matter if it's like, you know, just to be clear, as an admiral, Darth Vader gives plus 10%. You don't just negate the minus 10%. It's not like plus 10 and minus 10, therefore you get zero bonus. It's plus 10. Because this is completely ignored. The minus 10, as long as you have a better admiral, the worse admiral is completely ignored. You can't stack admirals and so on. If I stick the other 5% guy in here with him, I don't get a 15% bonus. Just to be clear. for the, anyone that did not know that. I'm going to get something damaged here at Kessel. I'm sure. Basically, this is the reverse form of the riot, the governor control. This is, basically, it's like the rebellion got the riot mission on me at Kessel. So they get to do that, and I need to negate it by getting a governor there. And I'm not going to be able to do that. So, the best I can do then, I guess, is to increase my defenses here.
Training soldiers.
I don't know. I'll do that. But this is messed up, the idea of it being some far-flung place. If it were down here, then I might be able to burst through. Like, if I can break through here, then I could actually do something. I could join up and be able to get some. But of course, I've already ended up having someone down here. You know, I have a governor down here already. Don't have one out here, though. Well, how about this? Give me a chance to think about it and so on. We're past the half hour mark. I do like kind of trying to keep them shorter. I plan on doing episodes of these at least one a day. And so hopefully we'll be able to have some stuff for you to watch. I hope you enjoyed this one, even though not a whole lot happened. It seems kind of looking dull, but I'm holding on. The only thing I've lost so far is Jaeger Miner, I think, and I was fully intended to lose it. I withdrew from Jaeger Miner. I haven't picked any. I picked up Intersection 5, but that's it. But so we're a lot like where we started, but we're building up defenses and building up the economy. So, until next time, I'll see you all for episode 3. Do like, subscribe, leave a comment, if you will. I love comments. Just say whatever in the world you think. And I will see you all for episode 3. Goodbye now.